Volkswagen versus Opel, the classic confrontation. In the family transporter sector, both marques score high in the new registration statistics. Whereas from 1998 to 2003, the Sefira was the segment leader, Opel were overtaken by the VW Touran in 2004, and they've held the top spot ever since. But with the next generation Sefira, the goal is to topple the Touran. Some Opel clients see this as a real possibility. The value for money question is convincingly answered. We used to have the older Sefira. The new one is 15 centimeters longer than the predecessor model and at 4.47 meters, 8 centimeters longer than the Touran. The similarity to the Astra is intentional and suits the Sefira well. A new feature is the bi-xenon lighting array, which now also responds to cornering. For such a beast of burden, the rear end is quite graceful. With the 150 horsepower diesel, the Sefira can reach over 200 kilometers an hour. The price? Just over €28,000 for the Catch Me version. The Touran may have 10 horsepower less than its rival, but it goes almost just as fast, and the Trendline version is also €700 less expensive. Great value for money. We want to have a German-built car and one with plenty of room. Those were important points for us. The latest facelift gives the Touran a peppier front aspect, more family-friendly than before. The chromed radiator grille and the prominent headlights suit the Touran well. Not much change at the back. It still has that rather clumsy breadbox form. The four-cylinder injection motor is a bit loud when given a cold start. The particle filter is an optional extra at €575. The TDI engine is reliable and delivers power spontaneously and fast. Nice to have for safe overtaking. Another plus, moderate thirst. It took 7.5 liters per 100 in our test, one more than the manufacturer claims. The six-gear transmission is well calibrated and delivers excellent precision with only short shift commands. The slightly rough-running engine and the limited RPMs above 3,500 are deficits, however. Touran bonus. For €700, VW make available an automated parking assist system. Two ultrasonic detectors in the bumpers register the clearance on both the driver and passenger sides. The driver activates the system by shifting into reverse, taking his hands off the steering wheel and using only accelerator and brakes. The automated parking takes only about 15 seconds. The suspension of the Opel guarantees a high level of stability. It compensates for uneven road surfaces very well and prevents the 1 meter 64 tall vehicle from swaying when cornering. It is in fact in the curves that the Sefira shows its sporty side. ESP comes as standard and can be counted on to keep the Sefira safely on course. In contrast to the Touran, the Opel motor has an even delivery of power. Overtaking is swift and sure. Praise is due also for the direct steering and, as we've said, the suspension. Our test called for 8.5 liters of fuel. That could be improved. The Sefira in Astra look. Chrome-framed instruments, high-quality materials, it's the right mix. We drove the Catch Me version, which includes ABS, CD radio, and air conditioning. However, there's less stowage space than in the Touran. The seats are firm and elegant, although supersized passengers will find it difficult to be comfortable due to the narrow construction. The fact that the Sephira has grown by 15 centimeters means more loading capacity and back row passenger space. Stowage in abundance, after all. The Flex 7 seating system, allowing a third row to pop up like a jack-in-the-box, is a Sephira highlight. When the third row is not called for, there's a huge 1,820 liters of cargo capacity. A pity that while the second row can be folded down, it cannot be removed. The Touran's interior provides the family more as standard, but for air conditioning, Volkswagen asks for an extra 400 euros. In general, things are well planned, the mix of materials is agreeable, the stowage possibilities generous. The Touran is really spacious. Even if only 4.4 meters long, there's room here too for 7 passengers. The boxy look is not perhaps so appealing, but it is practical. The third seating row is another optional extra. Then the seats can be sunk into the vehicle's floor with a simple pull of a lever. Even in the back row, adults can sit in comfort. But then, of course, load capacity shrinks to zero. The three second row seats are easily moved forward and back, folded down or completely removed. Then there's all of 2,000 liters of space to fill. Which model boasts the most room with seats folded down? Which can accommodate Granny's sideboard? The Touran wins, taking two more boxes on board than the Sephira. But both transporters are good for their task, transporting. We have plenty of space in the car. With kids, it's just perfect. We've been driving this one for 4 years and are still completely satisfied. To conclude, the Sephira impresses with a high level of standard features, including the particle filter, and points must be given for the very harmonious motorization. The Touran is in many ways a well-conceived and roomy vehicle with good safety features and driving characteristics, although we did have some minor electronics difficulties with the navigation system and cell phone integration. The VW is more spacious and more economical, but is unfortunately, in direct comparison, more expensive too. But it's a close result, and the team from Wolfsburg is just ahead.